Привет, друзья, and welcome to Russian Dacha. If you have no idea what Dacha is, you're missing out a huge part of Russian culture, because Dacha, or such kind of summer house, is a big part of life for thousands, maybe even millions of Russians, including my grandma, who is hiding in that building.
But before I show you our family's dacha, let's actually find out what dacha is all about. Google says that dacha is a country house in Russia, typically used as a second or holiday home. The word dacha comes from verb dat, to give, and originally refers to land that Russian tsars gave their loyal vassals. Back in 18th century, dacha was a huge piece of land belonging to noble people. No wonder that some dachas looked like palaces that time. Nobles used dachas as a place for social and cultural gathering. A century later, dachas became a favorite summer retreat for the upper and then middle class. It was still a large piece of land used for leisure. And only after the rise of the Soviet Union, dachas became something what you might see in modern Russia. Someone still used dacha as a holiday house, but for majority of people it became a place for gardening and food growing. Relatively small parts of land owned by normal people. Our dacha is around one third of an acre, and I'm 27 now, I can't really remember much from my childhood, but I do remember that my grandmothers put a lot of effort into gardening at our dacha. It's actually far away from home, my granny still goes there by bus, which takes more than an hour, but today we are taking a taxi. It's $4 for half an hour ride. Our agenda for today is to help my babushka and then chill with Russian barbecue, wine, family, just like nobles did two centuries ago.
It has been around 5 or even more years since the last time I visited my granny's dacha, and I can't believe it changed so much. The biggest difference is this house. It's entirely new, I haven't seen it being so good before. Now it's covered by that kind of grass, I don't know, that kind of plants, and looking good. And the old house that was in use for like many years, maybe 20, 30 years straight, is here. It's small, not really convenient to use, but we only had this one before.
Now this old house is something like a storage unit for all kinds of dacha instruments, and for this lovely Chebarashka too. Apparently, these buildings also works well as the grape tree support.
Let's see what is inside of this new house.
Have some instruments, some kitchenery here. Over here we have table with, wow, a half of bottle of beautiful, delicious wine, and also Omsk mineral water. Here's the bed, which is actually a very nice one, and a Russian-style, Soviet-style carpet. It still can be found here. Of course, here is something to heat the entire house. It actually works very, very well. There's a refrigerator, an electronic kettle. Oh, here's a light. And you can see it better, a tiny electronic oven, some water, and the second floor.
We have more beds over here, like
1, 2, and 3. And also some security. It's actually a huge problem for Russian dachas. Most of them are empty during the winter, no one lives there, and thieves often steal instruments or electronics, and the owners try to protect their dachas.
Oh, and I didn't show you this area of the house. It's actually indoors, like something in between indoors and outdoors. You can wash your hands here, like it's a kitchen corner, and a place to have lunches and dinners. That's where we had food today. And also a rest zone with a sofa and a chair.
Right in the center of this land we have a chill zone with a table and a sofa swing. That is really nice when the weather is not too hot. And if you wonder where the toilet is, it's also here. I actually don't know why it's right in the middle. Not the most comfortable thing, but okay. And here is a shower next to it too.
Overall, what you see makes this dacha, I think, like a very good one among the dachas I saw in Russia. And looks like my granny just called me.
Granny called me to work a little, so enjoy watching me getting dirty while I share a bit more about this place. The only thing I didn't show to you yet is the plants. Over the last 20 years, my granny tried to grow a lot of different stuff. The entire dacha was covered by growing food and there literally wasn't a free space on our land. It was not too long ago when she decided to leave some space for the resting area, and now she grows much less stuff. Along the fence there's bushes of raspberry, she also has a barberry tree, which is very nice for cooking Russian plov. You already saw the grape trees, I just took a bit of it for our table. Of course, granny grows some strawberries. Here's the potatoes, the bell peppers, and these tiny chili peppers.
It's actually really nice to see this kind of stuff. A few years ago, I was traveling China with my mom, and we brought some Chinese chili pepper seeds, and apparently they grow very well here in Siberia.
Flowers are all around the garden too, which is no surprise. What surprised me a lot was the real almond tree.
Вот они какие, ну это миленькие, вот видишь?
Да, ух ты.
Потом он трескается и вылазит орешек.
Какой интересный вообще.
After working a bit in the field, it's time for a Russian barbecue. I make the fire while talking to my mom, my auntie deals with the meat, and then I cook it on our brick mangal. We don't really use grills in Russia, instead we use such a simple construction and cook the meat on hot coals.
That looks so good and smells too. 10 more minutes, maybe 5 more minutes and it's ready. Feeling hungry. And here's my mom cooking the vegetable barbecue.
Here's our table. The barbecue and the homemade wine are the main things today. We also have some fruits and sweets on the table.
Can you believe this one is homemade wine? I have no idea what berry or fruit was used for making this wine, but we gotta figure it out.
So here's the wine. I was thinking that it's made from cherry, but apparently it isn't. It's actually made from black rowan berry, which is this kind of berry. I'll show you. This very one. That's sour, but wine from this tastes really good. Cheers, my friends. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and learned at least something new about Russia and Russian culture. I also want to thank my Patreon community for supporting me on my creative way. See you next time!